Good morning. It's 6:13, December 9th, 2022. Today's workout is a 20-minute leg, butt, and thigh workout.
Today, I'm going to lead you through a 20-minute full-on leg day workout using some dumbbells. Today, I have a set of 25-pound dumbbells and a set of 15-pound dumbbells, so something lighter and something a little bit heavier, but please use whatever suits your strength levels and whatever you have access to at home. Make sure that you can see your screen so you can follow along with me. And without further ado, let's get to it.
Mini is 10 and 15.
All right, guys, we're gonna start off with a really quick warm-up. Legs are nice and wide, arms are up to the side. You're going to reach fingertips to the opposite toes. Hinging at the hips, you'll feel a slight stretch through your hamstrings. Drive the knees upward, nice big half circles, warming up those hips. And next up, we're just gonna do some body weight squats, nice and slow, just warming up those legs. We are moving into our workout portion. First up, we're gonna do some sumo squats. So I'm gonna grab just one of my 25-pound dumbbells. The way that this is going to work is each exercise, we are going to do 40 seconds on with a 20-second rest, and we're going to repeat each exercise 3 times in a row. So 3 repetitions. So we're gonna do some sumo squats first. Legs are wide, toes are out on an angle. Grabbing the dumbbell, chest is lifted, coming up, keeping the tension on the glutes, not hinging the hips forward. Sit into those heels. Structuring, especially my leg day workouts like this, because it's really important that we focus on form, and this way we're just taking it one exercise at a time. Here we go, one more time. Is on the glutes. Side work. Last 20 seconds rest. I'm going to repeat that one more time before moving on to our next exercise.
If you guys notice, I'm taking my time. I'm not trying to keep up with her. I've learned. It helps me focus on form.
Here we go. Last round.
And my breathing. I'm listening to our instructions. Trying to have my hips go straight down.
15 more seconds, you can do it.
Keeping my weight in my heels, not leaning forward. Squeezing my butt when I come up. Chest up, head up.
Nice work. All right, so we're taking a 1 minute break. So you get a little bit longer of a rest here in between exercises. Next up, we are going to do some plain old deadlifts. So I've got both of my dumbbells, legs are about shoulder width apart. You want to focus on hinging those hips, sending the booty back nice and far, sitting into those heels, and then your palms are facing toward your shins. Back is in a nice straight line, hinging at the hips and squeezing those glutes at the top. If you find that this exercise is straining your lower back too much, really focus on hinging at those hips. When somebody is holding you back, if that's still not working, you can put something underneath your toes to help yourself really sit into those heels, and that should help. Here we go.
I believe this is the exercise that hurt my sciatic nerve last time.
Make sure your head, neck, and back are all in a nice straight line. Too much time at the bottom of your rise. If you have a stair nearby, or maybe even some yoga blocks, you can stand on that, having your heels hang off your back, and that will give you a little bit more range of motion. But if not, it's totally fine to do it on the floor, just like me. you're doing this, don't forget about your upper body and your core. Toes. Keep those legs straight. Either hand. If you can only hold one dumbbell, that's fine. Just hold it up by your chest like so. You're just going to be stepping back into a lunge, and we're going to alternate legs. Nice and simple. Make sure when you're stepping back into your lunge that your body is leaning slightly forward. The hinge point is on this glute, and you're pressing through the supporting heel to come back up to center.
These are my 15-pound weights, guys. The heavier ones that I have.
Here we go. Press through that heel. Do our last rest before we go into round two. If you feel like you cannot go any further, drop those weights and continue doing this just body weight. You're gonna press your hips all the way up to the ceiling and lower. Your back in this position. Protect that lower back by pressing it into the floor as you come down each time. Good work, last round, and then we are donezos. Here we go, really push yourself this round. Just tap that booty to the floor, spring it right back up, squeeze those glutes as hard as you can. Down to the floor. Whew. That is it. great job. All right, guys, I hope you enjoyed this leg workout. If you did, make sure to give this video a thumbs up. Let me know in the comments if you'd like to see more of this style. Did you like the way that this workout was structured? The way that we did three exercises in a row? Let me know in the comments. If you're new here, make sure that you hit that subscribe button, turn on your post notifications so you don't miss another video from me.
We'll see you guys very soon.
Bye.
Alright guys, I'm going to do a little stretching for my lower body, since one was not included in the video, but that's pretty good today. I'm sure I'll feel the burn tomorrow. You guys do something positive today for your mind, your body, your soul, and of course for someone else. All right, you guys take care. Don't be so hard on yourself.